To this now, KwaZulu-Natal police have recovered explosives at an abandoned house in the Brantville area in Mooi River. National Police spokesperson Vishnaidu says the explosives have been confirmed to be Viper Booster, which are generally used in mining. Naidu says this is not the first time these types of explosives have been recovered. For more on this, we are joined on the line by Brigadier Vishnu Naidu. He's the national spokesperson for the SAPS. Vishnu, thank you so much for your time this afternoon. Always a pleasure speaking to you.
A very good afternoon to you, Nati, and thank you so much for this opportunity.
Talk to us about these explosives. How did you uncover them, and what exactly are they used for?
Well, Onati, the way we uncovered them was purely through intelligence. Our intelligence from our national aid office received a tip-off initially that there might be this consignment of explosives being circulating, particularly in KwaZulu-Natal. And of course, they followed up, and then this led them to this abandoned house in Brantville in Mooi River in KwaZulu-Natal. And at this house, they discovered this these explosives, as you rightfully said. They are explosives that are generally used for mining purposes. We have recovered similar types of explosives before, which explosives we know were used for in ATM bombings, the automated teller machine bombings, as well as cash in transit heist. So we, although not confirmed as yet, but we suspect that these explosives may have been intended for these purposes.
Now, how concerned are you? I mean, it is the festive season period, and also there are so many, stories that we are hearing, unconfirmed reports, of course, on social media platforms about a number of things that are intended to happen, particularly in KwaZulu-Natal, particularly also following, you know, that a court case that we've just recently heard that pertains to former President Jacob Zuma. As the SAPS, how concerned are you about this discovery?
Well, like I said in my statement earlier, this is not the first discovery of such explosives that we've made. We have made similar discoveries before, and we want to assure the nation that because the fact that we made this discovery is an indication that our efforts to put measures in place to safeguard people, to ensure that they are and feel safe before, during, and after the festive season is proving to be very successful. Our festive season operations were launched on the 15th of October in Brits in the Northwest Province, and there's continuous engagements with the public and the media by our Minister of Police, the National Commissioner of Police, the Deputy Minister of Police as well, in the compliance visit of these operations. We've done Limpopo, Mpumalanga, we've done Northwest Province, we'll be moving to Eastern Cape, Western Cape, KZN, to ensure that what we have outlined in our operational planning for the festive season is indeed what is being executed. So for the nation at large, we want to say to them that we have deployments all over the country. All over the country, we have identified hotspots in the country where we are focusing more of our attention and resources as far as the convergence of people to these areas are concerned in terms of tourists and tourism. Mm. And we have been doing this on an ongoing basis every year in, year out, in the middle of the year, during school holidays, during festive periods, during peak periods. We have been doing this, and we've been learning from our improving on our good best practices, learning from mistakes that we may have made in the past, and we have we're improving as far as that is concerned in terms of road safety, ensuring border safety, route safety, hotel safety, people moving around to the beach, to other tourist destinations, and so forth. So our deployments are there, and as we are approaching the peak of this festive season period, we are enhancing in terms of our capacity and capabilities to make sure that the people visiting South Africa and visiting these tourist destinations are and feel safe.
Vishnu, other unconfirmed reports say that, you know, that these explosives would have been used to blow up the Moy River toll plaza. Please, can you just give us some insight on that?
I see that this is being communicated on the social media platform. Mm-hmm. I want to say, without fear of contradiction, that this is information that people are putting out there, in a very malicious and irresponsible manner. We'd rather the nation listen to what official reports are being communicated. As far as we know, that, like I said, generally, although not confirmed, we suspect that these explosives may have been intended for automated teller machine bombings as well as cash in transit heists. Now, we're saying this because we knew that these are the type of explosives that were used in the past for these type of crimes. But we're still saying it's not yet confirmed, right? Mm-hmm. Similarly, one cannot go and now be, with this degree of malice, be making such remarks, such comments, and projecting such narratives in the public domain, because this serves no purpose, only the only purpose it would serve is to bring anxiety and uncertainty amongst our people. Mm-hmm. Until we know for sure, people should know that police are on the ground, crime intelligence, joint security forces, SAPS, all the traffic departments, the metro police and so forth are all on the ground. We're working, and the recovery of these explosives is the fruit of the work that we are doing day and night throughout the country.
And Vishnu, I think that is encouraging to know that, security forces are out in their numbers, making sure that, to the best of their abilities, that the country is safe. Now, recently it was announced that the Defence Force would also be mobilised to help the SAPS in terms of their operations. Can you confirm to us if this is the case, if SANDF have been deployed or are they currently on standby? What's the current situation or scenario as they are concerned?
Onati, I want to beg to differ with you. I've never heard this announcement. I've heard the press briefing of the Justice Cluster ministers. I've heard the interviews by the Minister of Police, General Becky Kwele. I've never once heard anyone confirm the deployment of South African National Defence Force members for these operations at this stage. But of course, if there should be a deployment of the South African National Defence Force, there's a process that must be followed. There must be a request made to the Commander-in-Chief of the President of our country, and only when the President approves this, then a deployment will be made. But so far, there hasn't, as far as I know, there hasn't been that request, and there hasn't been that authority granted.
All right. Just as a final, as we wrap up this conversation, you said that the festive season operations have started since October. How are they going so far?
They started on the 15th of October, Onati. They're going very well. We have made significant successes as far as the proliferation of firearms are concerned, drugs and so forth. But what I want to say is that we are very, very excited about the cooperation we are receiving from the general public. But we want them to continue to adhere to our awareness and education programs as in terms of the way they conduct themselves on the roads. We're not going to tolerate drinking and driving. We want people to also adhere to the curfew in terms of the lockdown. They must continue to wear their masks at all time. We're still in the middle of the pandemic. They must continue to wear their masks at all time. Maintain social distancing with this Omicron variant. Now we know throughout the world it's spreading like wildfire. So we want people to while enjoying the festive season, they must do so in a very responsible manner, both to prevent themselves from becoming victims of crime or committing crimes, as well as preventing themselves from becoming infected or from being infected by the COVID-19 virus.
All right, Brigadier Vish Naidu there for us. We'll continue with more of your top stories when we return. Stay with us.